This is the Recovery Channel, where life's pains are healed.
Coming up next. Exclusively on Recovery Channel.
Hallelujah. I worship you. There is none like you, Jesus. For me, please. This place, let it rain, let it rest. Let your glory fill
this place.
Let it fill this house. Let it fill the temple of your Jesus.
This place.
Fullness of joy in our delight. There are pleasures forevermore. Nothing
can compare
to the beauty of your holy presence.
In your presence,
every man, woman, boy, and girl needs some healing in certain areas of their lives. At Sovereign Word Church invites you to Heal and Reign, a miracle service every third Sunday of the month by 7:30 a.m. at the Lagos State Arts and Culture Center, number 133 Obafemi Awolowo Way, opposite Zenith Bank, Radio Bus Stop, Alausa Ikeja, Lagos, and 9 a.m. at Sovereign Word Church, number 11 Awori Street, Ilekwal Haji Bus Stop, Egbeda, Lagos, ministering Dr. Anthony Oko. Come and experience the healing and miracle power of God. Don't miss it.
Coming up next, Moment of Recovery. Exclusively on Recovery Channel.
Devils come and they go. Jesus says so. How do we keep them out? Should be our focus. Amen. I say amen. Amen. Altars are real. Father's altar, demonic or bondages and all those things, they are very real. Matthew's Gospel chapter 12 verse 43. See the patterns of spirit. Can we all read it together? One, two, go. When an unclean spirit is gone out of a man, he walketh through dry places, seeking rest, and findeth none. What does he do? He says, then he said, I'll return unto my house from whence I came out. And when he's come, he findeth it empty, swept and garnished. See, that's where this is what we're going to work on tonight. How do we make sure that when we are delivered, the house is not empty? When he finds the house empty, look at what he does. Then goeth he and taketh with himself seven other spirits. Hey, that's not even the fearful side. More wicked. That means, after deliverance, there are some people who were delivered from high blood pressure, epilepsy. That's, see, listen, if you are not ready to go all the way, don't even start it. Touch your neighbor, say, if you are not willing to go all the way, don't even start it, because you will die. I didn't say so out of bad mouth, but it's the truth. Many years ago, I'll never forget, we had a 21 days fasting and prayer. A young man came at the end of the 21 days. He said, I want to thank God for the prayer and fasting. I want to thank God for this church. I'm a security man. I started fasting and praying. I don't know what went wrong, but the fasting ended yesterday. I lost my job yesterday. Thank you, Jesus. Have you not seen people who went for deliverance and after deliverance they died? That's what the Bible is saying. Have you not seen some people after deliverance you expect that they'll be more committed in church? Huh? You see them manifest. Bah! Usher's teeth, wig, fingernails, everything will be flying. Heels will be broken. Blows, blood will be coming out of the nose of ushers trying to hold the person. Then you say, hey, this person has seen the power of God. The next day you see the person pass church with a straight face. Seven more wicked spirits have come back. Seven more wicked spirits. Because the person was empty. Somebody say empty. Is the emptiness we're going to talk about today. How do we get this people filled? These are people when they go to places and they start shouting fire. Hey, fire, prayer. They walk away. The spirit say, move, move. This place is not conducive. And they walk out. And then they want to be part of a church that prayers are not offered. They want to be a part of a church that they come in 30 minutes, the service is over. Fast food church. The spirit is more comfortable in such environment. Their condition worsens. That's why you see a lot of times people get healed. They drop their crutches. They testify. 6 months later, you hear they died. You see, the church today, we are more interested in getting out the devil. We are not thinking about getting filled with the Holy Ghost. There's no vacuum. It's either you're filled with God or you're filled with the devil. There's no vacuum. Listen, I started casting out devils when I was 14 years. So I've seen things happen. I've seen people prayed for, and I've seen them die after prayer. I've seen people stand on the altar, give testimony, how they were healed, how they were set free, how the power of prayer of deliverance came upon them, how they were loosed, and the whole church rejoiced, and they came with people, and they did thanksgiving. 6 months later, 1 year later, that same sickness now comes times two, sometimes times seven, and then overwhelms them, and they die. And they say, but she testified. Do you know there are some churches today still circulating handbills, magazines of people who were healed, but they are dead as I speak. There are some church television programs, you see, they are playing repeated footages of people who got healed. And the Bible says that same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in our mortal body. That same spirit will quicken it. Lift up your hand and say, oh God. Oh God. I thank you for resurrection power. I thank you for resurrection power. Let your power rest upon me today. From the crown of my head to the sole of my feet. Let every evil power and evil presence in my life be destroyed. Never to rise again. In the name of Jesus. Jam your hands, everybody. Amen. I will never be an architect. I will die a preacher and a minister. This is what I will do all my life. And when you are into something that you are committed to and you see issues, you sit back, you go into your laboratory. Many years ago, Toyota produced a brand of cars and they discovered that in the mass production, all of them had one common defect, brake failure. And Toyota announced and they withdrew it from circulation. Manufacturers have produced things and they discover the side effects and it has been withdrawn. Doctors have, pharmacists have produced drugs and then the drugs was meant to cure and they discover the side effect was worse than the cures it brought. It was withdrawn. How many of you know today you don't see codeine in the market anymore? Huh? Call some names now. Huh? Fosin. That drugs have been withdrawn. Dr. Dema, give me one name. Novagene. It has been withdrawn. Why? Because of the damages. As a pastor, the things you see as you minister to people, the things you see over the years as you travel and you see issues, you need to address them. You need to go to your laboratory and see that and say, why is this thing like this? You need to get answers. A great man of God by the name Kenny Hagin, he said he did deliverance, all kinds of deliverance services. People will manifest some assault. He said, a few months later, not one of them stayed delivered. And then he looked back. What could be the missing factor? My prayer today is that this few minutes, somebody will receive something that will impact his life forever. Amen. Jesus said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. What you receive is what will keep you. Pastors have been called names. Prophets have been called names. Oh, they are fake prophets. If he is genuine, how come his prophecy did not come to pass? He prophesied. But look at the person he prophesied to is dead today. Look at the person he prophesied to, he has lost his job. Sure, they called him out. They said he has a great star. How come his life is gone the other way? Look at that man. They said he's going to be successful. I have a prophet friend. I respect him highly. He called a woman out. He called her case. He said, Mama, your son is a footballer in Italy. The mother said, yes. He said, you have a daughter. He called the daughter's name. He said, she's having a problem with our egg. Mathematics, this is what she got. English. And the whole church shouted. He said, Mama, your son, they're going to sign him on in a big club. And he prayed for Mama. He said, you have high blood pressure. As he prayed for this woman fell and the spirit cried out. And she was healed. Her BP stabilized. And the church was excited. We need to ask, that things we need to do, researches we need to conduct. The weakness of the church today is this: we are so possessed by making money that we don't take time to study. Many years ago in the 80s, when the Word of Faith Revival came to Africa, Christians were known to buy books. Christians were known to read books. You are passing the house of a believer, you'll be hearing sermon tapes. You, how do you know a believer? In the traffic, you'll be hearing sermon tapes. But today, chop my money. Who is playing the CD? Deacon Afolabi. African magic has taken the place of Bible studies in the home. African magic has taken the place of night devotion, money devotion. There are many housewives, they hold the remote control till 5 a.m. changing channels. And then they come back and they say, I don't know what's happening to me since I joined that church. My life have not changed. And then rather than change, they change church. Now let's look into the scripture. The challenge here, can we see the challenge here? The challenge is not that the power of God is weak. Come on, look at me now. Something was driven out. Is that not so? And then he goes through dry places because we have more devils than human beings on earth. The number of devils outnumbers the number of human beings. So demons don't find expression in another embodiment. So he goes through dry places. He says, I will return back to my house, because he couldn't find house somewhere else. But now he knows that he has been evicted. So he now goes and gets seven that will help him to hold ground. Seven other homeless, frustrated demons that have lost their accommodation, and they know what it means to keep accommodation. Have you seen some women, when they marry the second time, they spoil their husband. They pamper him. You know why? Because they were careless with their first marriage. There are some women today, if they remarry, they will pamper the man. Some people say it, if I see man, I will spoil him. There are some experiences you go through. Even you, if I can get a job, I will wake up early. I will never talk to my boss. That is the condition of the seven other spirits. More wicked in keeping the accommodation. More wicked. You say, bros, you found out that you want to go back to this. So let's go. Now look at the challenge here. Look at the challenge. Look up. Then he said, I will return into my house from whence I came out. And when he come, he findeth it what? Come on, talk to me. Findeth it what? And now the word we need to take here is empty. The challenge here is that the house became empty. Someone say empty. Let's go to the book of Ephesians. Ephesians 5. Lift up your right hand. Say, every strong man of my father's house or my mother's house that have entered my life since I was a child. Every strong man from my mother's altar, in the name of Jesus, you will never repossess me. I'm free because the Son of God have set me free. I am free indeed. I'm receiving the truth. I will receive the truth, and this truth that I receive shall make me permanently free. I will prosper like nobody has prospered. I will succeed like no one has succeeded. In the name of Jesus. And everybody say amen.
Amen.
Do you know everybody's buying books on prayer point, but nobody's buying books on how to be filled? Nobody's reading the scripture how to be filled. If you are not filled, there'll be a comeback. And not just a comeback, seven more wicked spirits. Come on. That means if care is not taken, you will be worse than your father. As a Christian with your big Bible, if care is not taken, your condition that you complained about is even going to be worse than your mother's condition. If your mother was divorced once, you might end up divorcing seven times in ministry. How do you know boys from masters? Masters are more interested in you being permanently healed. How do you know boys? They like the sensation. How would you like to go to a hospital, they treat your sore, and then you thank the doctor, you pay your bill. 3 weeks later, the sore opens up again. And you go back to the doctor, and the doctor says, oh, he takes the same drug. What happens to your faith? What happens to your faith? Huh? It drops. Because in your mind, this is what they gave me before. You want a doctor to give an explanation? You want a doctor to tell you something else? Because this thing he said was gone has come back. The Chinese proverb says, if you do the same thing the same way, you get the same result. So we need to find what to do to make sure that the house is not empty. Amen. Amen. Ephesians chapter 5 verse 1, it says, be therefore followers of God as their children. Followers of God. That means after you have been delivered, touch your neighbor's shoulder. After you have been delivered, be a follower of God. You went for deliverance service. The meeting ended. Straight to a viewing center. Waiter, to God be the glory. Can I have a stout? It was a powerful meeting. Bro, sorry I came late. Now my friend, I just dragged me, go one church. Did you hear the statement? The altar of his father's house is hearing. Now my friend, I dragged me, go one church. The demon said, boys, where are you? Let's, he said, look, hear a statement. My friend, I take me, go one place. Don't be smarting today. That's why I begin to shake. Next, I begin to vomit. They vomit. I said, now, maybe this show. Now, they come put microphone from my mouth. Now, I begin to share testimony. Bros, that's why I was late. Madam Bear brings stout for everybody, two bottles. Let's just give him glory. Now, he doesn't go back to church. Oh, boy, now the man seeing him. Say this thing, now my papa village, this thing start. He won't tell me, saying I supply, I come, I shock. The man say, see 4-3. He said, I mean, I'll be for my family. I said, we'll be four. Sure. I said, so people, they see like this. The man, they see, oh. Now, he's not talking about God. He's talking about a man. That's why in the book of Ephesians chapter 5, it says, be therefore followers of God as their children. Church should not be a panadol that you take to be free, and you don't want to have anything to do with church after you have been free. You don't seek God because you are 44 and you are not married. Now you are married, you are not interested in church. He says, as therefore God's children, be ye what? Followers of God. Go to the next line. And walk in love as Christ also had loved us and had given himself for us as an offering and as a sacrifice to God for a sweet smelling savour. Number one point here tonight. If there's anything that brings in devils into a man's life, it's when you walk in bitterness. Someone say bitterness. I don't care who delivered you. If you have bitterness against your father, you have bitterness against your mother, you are still exhibiting bitterness against people, that is an open door. Touch your neighbor, say open door. He says walk in love. God cannot possess a heart that is bitter. Listen, I have a pastoral heart. I'm not a display guy. I want results. What do I get? I'm doing deliverance. All your bangles are on the floor. Two ushers have lost their teeth. At the end of the service, shoes are broken. Fingernails are on the floor. Church is over. Ushers are massaging their hands in the house. Then, 4 days later, again, you show up. They say, strong man manifest. Strong man manifest. You can't do like ushers. Say, not be me. Oh. Not be me this time. Not be me. Some people, do you know some ushers, when they say, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus. Do you know some people, even now when they won't scare them away from that church, say that church now, so devil food the place, so everybody. I don't want to mention, there's a church in this city now, I don't want to mention the church. Come. Every day, from morning to evening, they have apostles pray. Who are you? I'm a strong man. How did you enter? From village. What village? Kogi State. I was watching that one day on cable. It was an Hausa boy. They brought. Who are you? Kai, you don't touch me, small boy. The man said, who are you calling small boy? I said, you are a small boy. I came here to see your master. Call your master. But is that what a church should be? We are not to be casting out demons. Believers should cast out demons. We shouldn't be casting out demons from believers. You must grow. You should be saved. That could be a process, but should not be a pattern. Every 2 weeks. Who are you? Strong man. Abba. Even me, I go tired for that job. The service that should be closing by 8:30 is 12 o'clock. Because of one person that will not listen to what I'm sharing this morning. Do you know why I'm saying so? We are having a series of deliverance tonight. It will be permanent in Jesus' name. Into your heart, you must walk in love. Do you know Jesus till the end? He never allowed bitterness to possess him. Even in death, he said, Lord, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Because he couldn't imagine the man he healed the sister's eyes was the one carrying the spear slapping him, piercing his head. Now, at that point, he could be bitter. Do you know if he was bitter? If he was bitter, his mission would have been truncated. Satan would have wounded him big time. When he entered hell, they would have pinned him down. On the third day, the disciples would have waited in vain. Even in death, when I was a little child, when I read that scripture, I was angry. How can he say, forgive adults, for they don't know what they do? I can't do that. How about, they know what they are doing. They keep us and say they don't know. But you see, he had to release them. Lift up your right hand, somebody. Say, I release everyone that's hurt me. Everyone that hurt me. I release them. I don't see them. I see the devil. Oh God, help me to forgive my husband, my friend, my colleague, whoever betrayed my trust, whoever hurt me. Lord, help me to release them. No bitterness in my soul. God is love. I create an atmosphere for God to find a place in my heart. Somebody shout out here. Someone shout out here. Someone shout out here. Someone shout out here. Someone say, I hear. Now listen, when you deal with bitterness, you create room for God to come into your life. Now when God comes into your life, there's a fellowship and there's a presence. What makes all the difference in your life? What puts away the enemy? What puts away the strong man of your father's altar? Is the presence of the indwelling Christ in your life. And his life and his presence cannot possess you when you are bitter. You see where we are going this morning. Are you hearing me? There are women who can't forgive their husband. There are people who cannot forgive their last boyfriend. And that's why your testimony is still hanging. Touch your neighbor and say, are you listening? Touch your neighbor and say, are you listening? You that have bitterness in your heart, are you hearing me? Do you know somebody? When you talk, they say, listen, come. You have done another one. The one you did last year, next month will make it 1 year. That means they are keeping records. Next week, we make it 1 year. You didn't even allow them to mature. You have started another one. Today, I will tell you that from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence. And only the violence take it by fault. When I beat you finish, I will ask God for forgiveness. Somebody say, God is all I need in me. Please go back to the verse. It says, walk in what? In love. Walk in love. Now listen. There's a great man of God in America. He died a few years ago, Kenny Hagin. He talked about love, love, love. Kenny Copeland is teaching love, love, love. Some great men of God, apostles of faith, they're teaching love, love, love. You know, we don't like hearing messages like that. The work of love, love, I beg. We would like to buy books on courses, covenants, altar versus altar. Give me that book. Give me that book. Sometimes when you read wider, you will see the importance of other factors that you play down. As big as a car is. Is somebody hearing me? One tiny wire can disconnect and nobody can move the car 1 inch. This, as I speak, could be why somebody is always repeating deliverance and going for deliverance. Bitterness. If I stand somebody this morning and say, stand up. God said there's bitterness in your heart. Forgive. You say, may see big thing, see strong thing. Not be that one. If you read the book of 1 John, you find the whole of 1 John talking about love, love. They need to walk in love, to forgive. The Bible says, if we say we hate the ones we see, how can we say we love the one we don't know? It talks about how love, 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 love. And the Bible says, if any man does not know love, he does not know God. For God is love. When he says something is, that means is the sum total. If I say this thing is black, it means there's no white. What are you seeing in my hand now? This is a black Bible. Is any white? Because it is black. So if God will come into my heart, I must walk in love. For God is love. If I don't want to see altars, the influence of altars, strong man coming back to repossess my life and take my goods and take my breakthroughs and steal my wife, steal my children, steal my blessing. I must walk in love. Somebody say, walk in love. People who love live long. Check. Loving people are always happy people. People of strife, they're always having arthritis, high blood pressure, one sickness. Because when you are filled with strife, all manner of evil will abound. You have become a dustbin for the devil to throw his trash. Do I make sense to anybody this morning? All right. That's point number one, walk in love. Always forgive, no matter what you see in life, no matter what happens to you, no matter who hurts you, whether you have a reason to be angry, you discover your husband's phone, there's text messages from a girlfriend, say, honey, this thing is painful, I forgive you. And start confessing, I forgive, I forgive, I forgive, until your heart. One woman said, can't you allow me to finish preaching? I just saw a lady's head just shake, say, not in my house, though. The blackberry will enter inside the brain. All right. Walk in love as Christ had loved us and had given himself for us as an offering and as a sacrifice to God for a sweet smelling what? Savor. All right. The next verse, please. This is a serious one. But fornication and all uncleanness or covetousness, let it not be once named among you, has become a sense. The Christianity of today is a serious one. Do you know when you're preaching about fornication, everybody's wondering, who is he talking to? It's not me. He says, but fornication and all uncleanness or covetousness, let it not be once named among you. That means it should not be seen in your life again. Can I tell you, one of the easiest way entering points of demons is through sex. If a man has slept with 20 people, evil signs say that if he sleeps with you, a virgin, the 20 people have entered you. Did science prove that one man with multiple partners versus a virgin, Abby? Everything from those partners is transferred, is deposited. These are physical things. If he has a little bit of syphilis, a little bit of gonorrhea, a little bit of herpes, he will deposit it in that lady, though she's a virgin. Now, in the same light, in sex, the Bible says two become one. It's a merger of spirit. That's why sex should not be done outside marriage. Because in sex, two become one. There's a koinonia. There's a bond. There's a coming together. That's why you see a man and a woman, after having sex for a long time, they look alike. They talk alike.
Thank you for what I pray for you to be healed now. In the name of Jesus. There's somebody watching me right now. You're having palpitation of the heart. I pray for you to be healed. Call this number as you watch. There's somebody you're feeling weak, so weak you can't even come out of your bed. I pray that you be healed now. Call the numbers on the screen. There's somebody watching me right now. You are feeling like life is being taken out of you. The doctor told you have low blood pressure. Call this number. I want to pray with you. Be healed in Jesus' name.